Very good morning to students. Today we are going to learn the open cast mines subject, particularly the hands using in the open cast mines. My name is Karna Kumar, Chodi Mining. Different machinery using open cast mines is today's topic. Subtopic basically dozer and scraper, which are the hands we are using in mine. These are the elaborately discussing in the coming slides. We are well known that different machines for preparing the ground for mining operations are the dozer. Dozer is a very key machine in the machinery in the open cast mines. It is a major application is pull the all the heaps, this consolidated material into one side, and also ground preparation works. This is a playing role in the open cast mines. A scraper is also a small container is there for lifting of the waste material and carrying somewhere else. And also road grader is a very essential feature for the making of the gradient in the all roads, essentially activity. And also cleaning of some particular areas also required. But not carrying anything, it will be pushing and adjusting the road material there itself. And road roller is for compaction purpose, the compacting for the road roller is an essential feature. And cranes, lifting up the various machineries and one place other motors lifting, explosives carrying. These are the cranes can be utilized in the multi-purpose purpose. So from dozer, scraper, roader, grader, road roller, up to cranes. These are the generally called auxiliary equipment for major operations concerned. Excavator is concerned with drag lines and bucket wheel excavators, shovels are the excavators. Most of the well-known the drag lines exclusively for the open cast OB removal purpose. Bucket wheel excavator exclusively for the lignite mines, particularly it is available in the Naval Lignite Corporation and Gujarat Development Corporation. And shovels, we can get the two types of shovels available in market. One is the particularly well-known that one is the hydraulic shovels. These are back two type, and all other shovels are rope shovels, which are used for the high capacity bucket purpose. Next, surface continuous mining is one of the specific operation purposes for thin seam mining. Slice cutting, selective mining. Particularly in Singrana Polis area, the Koyikudam open cast mines, the control of Illandu area, these type of machines are available. Dozer is a major one of the mission for the using the open cast mine. It is simple crawler mounted and tractor mounted in front with hydraulic pistons for lifting purpose and also tilting purpose and pushing purpose. And also sometimes they are using backside power cover type of purpose. Most of these is a pushing purpose material, but is not carrying anything. Is adjusting the area itself in boats and also heaps settlements displaying a vital role. Scraper, this is also one of the special equipment, but we have a container. Some material collected here and taken away from so far away, but it is tire mounted scraper. These two we are elaborately going to learn in this lecture. Remaining machines are the road grader. Already we have the circle and the grade is there. Grade can be tilt any direction, any angle, depending upon the road designing. The access material can cut and settle there itself. Another is the drills are very important machines in the open cast is concerned, making up the blast holes. So these are different sizes also available depending upon the our usage. Whether you go to 100 mm, 200 mm, 300 mm diameter, the machine's capacity also there. And shovels, these are the rope shovels, are most of rope shovels are using in the market, particularly high capacity, bucket capacity are available. These are robust situations also, it will play a good results giving compared to the hydraulic shovel. Items are some sophisticated, and also the hydraulic shovel have some disadvantage. Maintenance of area and dusty areas is maybe more, but rope shovel is a rope robust conditions you can go work, and more high bucket capacity. Most of the rope shovel are used in the market. And then this is the bucket wheel excavator. We are only Navin Nicholas Corporation. These are available in also Gujarat Mineral Development Corporation is also. For lignite mines, there is exclusive use. So, surface continuous miner. This is a special for the avoiding the drilling and blasting. For the purpose, these are using. There is a roller is there, a long boom and the roller it picks up there. Against the ground, it will cut it and going on, moving the frame. This collected material will be thrown out through the long boom, but sometimes it not required. Some disconcerted material will be shoveled by the payloader and dumpers. But this thickness is 0.5 meters, can be cut at a time with the vehicle width. So, this is the hydraulic shovel. Hydraulic shovel with the back boom. This is a back boom. The boom will be just like towards the operator. It can be taken the material by seeing. So most of these advantages they stable in the high bench level and take into the lower. And next, dumper. These are the carriers of the most of the transportation in the mines. These are different sizes available, matching for the shovel to cycle of the shovel number of passes is concerned. The dumpers are most of the 35 ton dumpers are very low capacity. Now market is available 85 ton dumper, 120 dumper. 200 ton dumpers are available in the most of the coal mines. The simple engine type, there is a bucket. But this is the main major road with rare dumping for dumpers. So this is same dumpers with 35 ton dumpers. Lunch break or shift changing the heat into the another. Now these are the most of the machineries using in the open cast mine. The one second I indicate dozer, scraper, road grader. Drills, shovels, vertical excavator, surface continuous miner, backhoe, and dumpers. Now we go to the dozer. See the various parts of the dozer. There is a blade, operator seat, shoe lifting chain, driving sprocket. This is called the idle wheels, arms. The most of the mechanism of dozer is there will be basically this is the part is amazing. This is a curved shaped blade is there. There is a lifting arms for the lifting of the blade and pushing arms are there. The pushing of the blade, right? These are the main mechanism of the construction mechanism of the dozer. A dozer consists of a large vertically curved steel blade mounted at a fixed distance in the front of a tractor, secured by arms on a pivot or shaft near the originator center of the tractor. The sides of the blade generally extended behind the crawler or wheel of the tractor. And the blade itself can be raised or lowered or tilted vertically by means of the control cable or hydraulic rods. The operating weight of the dozers are 21,100 kg, 33,460 kg, and 44,900 kg. These are the gender three type of available. Then most of the classifications are there are six major type of dozer classifications are there. Stride or bulldozers, angle dozers, tilt dozers, push dozers, U-shaped dozers, brusher rock packs. These are the different types of the classifications of the dozers. One by one, you see the what is the stride or bulldozers. The stride dozers is a conventional dozers with a cutting edge and a blade at a right angle to the longitudinal axis of the tractor. The blade can be raised, lowered and tilted slightly, but cannot be angled to the direction of the travel. This type of dozers are used for the pushing material in a straight path, especially when operating in a self-cutting slots. These are the most of the open customers are these type of the bulldozers are straight type bulldozers are most popular. Angle dozers. In an angle dozer, the blade can be turned at an angle to the direction of the travel. For this purpose, the blade is generally actuated by the hydraulic wraps. It can be carried continuously full load at the greater speed than a straight blade can, even though it can its capacity is smaller. A particularly important feature is that it can be thrown off a window on a wedge edge of the blade, a feature of the required when the grading of all roads. It is also useful in cutting away the toss of earth embankment or making of hillside cuts. Most of the mines are using in the particular in the tail ponds management. Creation of the tail ponds purpose. Most angle dozers are play a vital role. Then tilt dozers. The tilt dozers is a modified of stride dozers as a blade which can be pinched through a vertical or a few degrees. When the top of the blade is pitched to the rear, it can cuts the better, which is advantage for hard material. When the top of the blade is pitched forward, its capacity for the carrying loose material such as light soil, other increasing bit. But tilt dozers are just like a straight one, but there is a vertical arc is more few degrees. And push dozers. The push dozers has a blade which has been reinforced at the center with the heavy steel plates. The shape and size of the plates and often the blade itself is such that the rear tire of the unit being pushed usually in a tractor scrap will not be damaged. This is one of advantage of that one. The primary purpose of push dozers is to make contact with the scrapper push block so as to combine its drawbar pull with that of the tractor scrap to speed up the loading of the scrapper and boost, which is a way you feel in the area. So this is the one of the primary purpose pusher dozer. It have only the reinforced forces there against the steel plate. The tractor capacity can be moved straight there. U-shaped dozers. These are the most of the dozers are shaped in front. Originator curve dozers, blade designed for straight pushing and free fall. This blade is an attempt to overcome the excessive blade roll of the material. U-blade carry large load, 20 to 30% more than the straight blade, but does not have its digging power. This can be improved by the fitting teeth at the corners. Brush or rock racks, a wide variety of blade modified includes racks, different size of the handle, brush and rocks. Stringers or shearer blades mounted on the dozers will cut all the largest trees. This is the one of the type. So these are the different type of dozers. Sometimes based on the wheel mounted dozers are there, crawler mounted dozers are there, dozer with the cable operated blades are there, dozer with hydraulic operated blades are also there. So what are the major components? So a dozer consists of a following components. A dozer consists of the following components. Basically, there are blade, arms, undercarriage unit, transmission system, and a blade operation system, cable control, and hydraulic control units. So a dozer consists of the following components: blade, arms, undercarriage carriage unit, transmission system, blade operation system, cable control, and hydraulic control units. These are the major components of the our as per the construction point of view parts of the dozer. This has a rectangular base and the back structure with the knife edge riveted to the bottom part. These are the attachment part actually. You can show the figure very clearly. This is the part of the blade. It will be a separate part and attached to the by bolts to the, it is the sharp in nature. Most of the damaged part is this one. So this can be replaced instead of entire blade replacing. Most of shear and or pressure will be taken this way. The body is a steel structure and the edge which projected ahead is made of hard steel. The steel structure is in hard edges which is projected in the ahead. The dimensions are the variable region of the design. But this is a general some blade dimension 4260 multiplied by 6060 is there, 3460 multiplied by 1280 mm, etc. These are the general dimensions. The edge is usually in three pieces, a wide center and two corner, which are bolted or riveted. They are the reversal type, reversible type. So it can be two sides can be used. Then arms. Arms provide the dozer blade are made of two parts. There are push arms and pitch arms. The both are the two types of arms are there. These are push arms are meant for exclusively for the these are heavy hollow beams connected from the hinge points of the body to the bottom of the blade. They are usually mounted on the outside track frame. However, there are some design where the frames are fixed on inside of the track frame. And pitch arms are, these are the diagonal brass members placed between the push arms and the top of the blade. They provide supports when load is above the line of the push arms. They are also help in controlling the pitch and tilt of the blade. They are either a single piece member or two piece member. Two piece members help in the lengthening or shortening of the pitch arm, thereby helping in forward and backward. So next is a dozer. That is a, what are the your the arms? These are the one arm. This is the part. is the Nifty norms. These are the, for whenever required to lift, will be, these hydraulic pistons will be lift the complete front part. And also these are sides, the arms are sides arms for pushing purpose. So you see here, this is a curved shape. Most of this area will be a capacity blow because of will be pushing over large material for one piston. This is the attachable and detachable blade. It can be used in a reversible side also. So the, when the applications, in the field applications, you observe these are the field applications. So the crawler also attached here for the purpose of because of the backside of material as well as pushing tab. Place of application of dozer. The main applications are usage of dozer. Clean the stumps of trees and shrubs to prepare the ground so that it is suitable for the movement of the drilling machine. To make the road base, to clear the roads from the boulders, to heat the boulders which are thrown apart due to the blasting. So the enabled excavation by the excavator. So these are the main creating the heap for the conveniente for the excavator. Making of the roads is also one of important. Prepare the ground is also one important. Cleaning up the bushes in around the area. So initial ground preparation. So these are the basic applications of the dozer. So other applications, land cleaning, stripping of soil, side hill. Cuts, excavation, spreading, dozing rocks or frozen ground, maintaining the hard road, clearing floors of bone and firing pits, throwing other piece of construction equipment, assisting scrappers in loading. So these are the other parts of the already heard. Some more detailed figure is given here. This is the bucket cylinder, this is the engine, the structure of the engine, this is the radiator of the engine, this is the basic bucket, or you can say blade, the curved shape blade, tilt cylinder, this can be the bucket can be tilted inside on this side. These are the side arms, these are lifting arms, these are side arms, track springs. Rollers, the hydraulic chain rollers, track group, idler, sprocket, final drive, ripper cylinder, cab, transmission power. So these are the generalized parts of the bulldozer. Now, a blade adjustments, how the blade is can be adjusted. Both are same figures, but this is the one side and the other side. How the blades can be adjusted. The vertical movement of the blade end is known as a tilt. The vertical movement of this movement of lifting the side is the one side. The vertical movement of the blade end is known as a tilt. This movement is within the vertical of the blade. The tilting permits concentration of the tractor driving power on the limited length of a blade. Limited length of the blade. It can possible to tilt this side, it's possible to this side. Sometimes small gradient, the scraper grader can be used, just like grader. But not much, that much light, like you can cut one side. Angle of blade, turning the blade so that it is not the perpendicular to the direction of the tortures. Travel is known as the angle. Angling causes the push of the material to the rough of roll of the traveling end of the blade. The procedure of the rolling material of one end of the blade is called the side cast. So this is one of the seeing here. The complete blade will be, this is a large angle is maintained. So this is a casting procedure. So pushing the material into one side to other side by this type of curved nature. Angle of blade. Here the blade is given. So the operation is shown here. Can be observed easily. Angle of blade is a wide face length by 1 to 2 feet, so then the S blade can be angled up to the maximum 25 degrees left or right, perpendicular to the tractor or head, perpendicular to the dozer line of the travel. The blade can be tilted, it can be pinched. The angle blade is very effective for the side casting material, particularly for the back filling or making side heel cuts. So these are different fashions of the blade movements. This is the blade, your side arm, so lifting, this is the blade face. So this is the angle maintained, then downward. This is the one better. The blade adjustment. turning of the blade so that it can it is not a perpendicular to the direction of the tractor traveling and this causes the push material to roll on the driving end of the blade. Rolling material of the end of the blade is called a side casting. So already here I show you here. How push that can be shown by the something. How to estimate the dozer production? If any bucket or something is there, if the carrying capacity can be measured. If you have any container, this much of this much of material will be transported from this place to this place. But here, how you estimate production, dozer is. In a dozer, it will only the travel push the material one place to other place. How the capacity can be calculated? This is the one big question. But coming, explain the how to production calculate. A bulldozer has a set of volumetric capacity. There is a no hopper or blower to load. The amount of material the bulldozer move depends. The amount of material that dozer moves depends on the quantity which will remain in the front of the blade during the push. The factor that control dozer production rate or blade type, type and condition of the material, cycle time. A bulldozer has a no set of volumetric capacity. There is a no hopper or bowl to load. The amount of material that dozer move depends on the quantity which will remain in the front of the blade during the push. The factors that control dozer production or rates are blade type. This is a blade type of the conditional material and cyclic. So these three factors you have to draw into your mind. So estimation of dozer production. The basic earth moving production equation may be applied in the estimation of dozer productions. This method requires an estimation of average blade load and dozer circle time. There are several methods available for estimation of average blade load, including the blade for manufacturing capacity rating. Previous experience, you have 1 hour if it is work. How much earth crust will be completed? These are the history can be calculated. Actual measurement of several type of loads. What are the loads it will be moving there from there to there? How many cycle times it work? How much of diesel is consuming also you can be calculated. So the performance is basically a quantitative in the field measurements. So dozer productions in fixed cycle times, man houring, gear changing, loading, dumping. A typical day dozer fixed cycle times are operating conditions, time in minutes, power shifting transmission 0.05 minutes, direct drive transmission 0.10 minutes, hard digging 0.1. This is a general experience by the time study management or time study people are giving the one calculus procedure. This time is required for this purpose. So most of them, when you go to the dozer operations in market, they say that for 1 hour we giving this much of amount. So 1 hour operation, what you are doing depending upon the topographic nature. Go to one field, yes, we want to for 1 hour 600 rupees, for 1 hour 1000 rupees they are asking. So 1 hour how much work is completed? So that is a major quantity to the dozer capacity is concerned. Now another calculations also I given simple calculations for the purpose. Output of bulldozer, output of a dozer in volume for hours. So loose volume handled by trips into number of trips into swell factor into 60 multiplied by time, cycle time and absence. These are the general phenomena, general bulldozer phenomena for this purpose. We easily understand the this is the activity. Loose volume of handling, the material completed and divided by how many trips are it making? What is the swell factor of that particular location and cycle time and efficiency? We can be 60 seconds per hour multiplied by the seconds. So this is efficiency. So overall, divided by the number of trips into 12 factories into efficiency is a major calculation for the bulldozer in volume per hour. That is a swell factor, this is the cycle time. For U-shaped blade height, blade depth, these are also intrinsic factors. That's why whether using straight blade is different, using curved blade is different. So these are also one of the volume handle trips, blade width and blade heights. This is a blade factor, cycle time in minutes, you can be candle. Some empirical formula also given for how to time calculate, how the cycle time is calculated. Here I am giving the cycle time, the T, how T is calculating. Here D is hall distance, F is the forward speed, the reverse speed, gear shifting time. So overall, the 25.3 into drawbar in horsepower divided by distance in meters is also the one of the output of the bulldozer can be calculated by empirical formula. This is also one important formula for the calculation purpose. Factors affecting the output bulldozer: size of the condition, size and condition of bulldozer, distance traveled by bulldozer, speed of operation, soil properties like moisture content, particle size, wide area, also their criteria, efficiency. These are the factors for the bulldozer output calculation purpose. So according to above previous experience, the estimation of the dozer production can be estimated. So I hope so far completely about the dozer, it's a place of application. What are the basic components of the dozer? Its types and blade movement, angle of the blade, and also how production calculations. These items we are covered in a particular science. Now I am going to the second topic, that is a scrapper. This is a scrapper. Observe, point out the various parts of the scrapper in order to the balance. Here you observe the most of the, this is the basic bowl is there, inside the bowl, the what are the cut material can be inside into the bowl. It will carry some distance and it can be lift the bowl and also open the front down. This is the hopper, the belly, push attachment is also given. This is the bowl. And given is a tractor attachment. So these are the scrappers. So this is the scrapper attachment. When the blade cut and the blade will coming to the inside. See, there is a mobile cutting. The cutting material is not stable here, it will be inside the bowl. Then this is also very clearly mentioned under parts of the bowel. The cutting edge is also very clearly shown in the bowel. Steering cylinder and rock goes neck of tract region compartment. Further elaborating the machine parts, components. So here is also road scraper, another view of the road scraper. So here is simply the operations where they move on this automatic, is attached to it. This is the general tractor, these are scrappers, they are separated. This model is different. You observe this. This is the NA2 parts of the middle, that's the power is provided. In this part, this comes with the tractor, there is this attachments, the scrapping attachment, box attachment. Then when it's moving, the metal will be inserting inside of the bowl. The operator can be close to the bottom and carry out from this place to other place and power it. One advantage is no need of the further process, that is, a person is staying here, loading and power into the bottom itself is the loading. This can, generally, the loading is uppers, that is a top to loading system is there. But here is the loading is in the bottom. The scrapper is specialty of the scrapper is the loading of the material in the bottom of the wick. There is a scrapper. Nothing is there. So you see here when the metal is cut, this will be entering to the upper. So this is a very mechanism. This is a simple mechanism you see here for understanding the process. Also line diagram I'm showing here. Very clearly, apron is there, cutting edge is there, bowl is there, scrap. This is the line diagram. For practice purpose, the previous figures are many images. For drawing purpose, if you want to how you drawing is not difficult. So that better to use for the drawing purpose, examination point of the drawing purpose. This figure is a variation. Please go through at glance. This equipment is designed to dig, load, haul, dump, and spread the material. The cutting edge on the front of the scrapper bowl, lower into the ground, and the forward motion of the scrapper causes energy to flow up into the bowl. This equipment can be classified in the following: self-propelled scrapper. This is self-movement making. Towed scrapper, both them can be either cable controlled or hydraulically controlled. These are also classified as a free haul forced and forced recharge type. They are also designated by the bowl capacity. They are also designated by the bowl capacity. So bowl is there, so bowl capacity can be calculated. Push load, single powered axle, tandem powered axles are the classifications. Self-loading push pulls, tandem powered axle, elevated anchors are the another models. Excavated loading, hauling, dumping over medium distance. It can be used with the pusher tractor to increase the production. Some models have self-loading capacities. Economically, over a wide range of the volume, can self-load depending on the other equipment. Scrapper are available with loose heap capacity up to about 44
cyclic per year can be used for purpose. Rubber tire self propelled tractor scrapper. Rubber tire self propelled scrappers have high haulage speed, which may be reach the as much as 50 km per hour. But sacrificing in the traffic efforts has to be made in terms of road holder capacity. The use of a pusher tractor, however, provide the extra effort when it is needed during the loading portion of the cycle. There are available, these are available in four-wheel units or two-wheel overhang units. Four-wheel units are usually selected for the projects required. Long haul at a very high speed of up to 50 km per hour. Their stability, smoothness of riding and ease of operation not only give the confidence to the operator, but also make them a safer unit to operate. Tower scrapper. The scrapper unit of this type usually mounted on four wheels. These wheels carry only the load of the machine and material. There are neither steered nor driven. This is attached at the rear side of the tractor. The individual motion of the scrapper body are performed by a two drum powered control unit mounted on the back of the tractor. These consist of the pair of the high-speed winches driven by the power track of the shaft and controlled separately the friction clutches and brakes. So this is a bowl structure is given here. So how the meter will be inside in the pump. This is the cutting edge there. This is the apron. This is the apron cables or bowl cables are there. The hinging points. The meter will be inside into the bow. So this is the line diagram. You can be draw pathetical lines for the purpose of the examination instead of Lego figures. This is a very convenient to the how the part will be showing. Different components. The following are the component of the components of the scrapper. These are the components you can be seeing. Bowl. This is one. The apron. Cutting edge. Transmission system. Steering system. Braking system. Control unit. These are the basically different components are using here. The bowl. The apron. cutting edge, transmission system, steering system, braking system, control unit, cable or hydraulic. The bow, this is a box type of container, open at the top. The bottom and the sides are part of the pod. The bowl may be shaped in a two-way box type or oval shape, and it is a lower portion. Sometimes a bowl is a hinged and a tip forward to the roll of the material out. The bowl holds the dirt, the material, what are the waste material dirt. Some scrappers, the bowls is hinged and it tips forward to roll the material out. Another tailgate, which is this wall in the rear, bowl is used to push the material out. The bowl is held in a position by two lift cylinder. The cylinders are mounted on a frame. Apron. The front wall of the bowl is known as an apron. This may be a straight wall or a curved wall, which is operated to control the material flow. This movement may be controlled by the cable or piston cylinder arrangement. The apron may be straight or curved wall in the front of the bowl, which open and close to the regulate the flow of air in and out of the bowl. The movement of the apron is also controlled by a separate piston cylinder arrangement. Cutting plate. This is made of the wear resistant steel bolted onto the bowl bottom, and it's made of three pieces. The middle one is a long and other two sides are the short in length. So this is the one important for the other than dozer. The cutting plate is a special made water resistance, wear resistance, sorry. Wear event means it is not more wearing nature. Bottom of the three pieces it can be put. The cut edging is lowered into the to make the shawl out scrapper rated according to the capacity strung. The heap perfectly both. The struck capacity is the maximum minimum volume of the liquid the bowl can be moved. Scrappers can be pulled either by crawler, tractor, or rubber tire, self-propelled tractor. Crawler tractors were the earliest employed, and are still in the wide use. Transmission system. The transmission system is similar to that of the dumper transmission system. The engine delivers power to transmission system, which finally drive the wheels through universal joints, universal joint, propeller shafts, and differential travel speeds are as follows: forward 8.5 km per hour to 44.1 km per hour. Reverse can be moved 44.4 km per hour. These are five forward gears. There is a five gear, one reverse gear is there. Total six gears are available in the transmission is concerned. Place of application of road scrapper. It is generally suitable for the scrapper loading and transportation of the soft material, but it cannot be not in a hard material because of the plate capacity is very low. Medium to hard, not possible. Roof and can be cut and lifting the material one place to other place. Estimation of the how the estimation of the bowl is there so that we can be carrying capacity. The main estimation of the production is concerned. Estimated production volume per cycle and cycle per hour into efficiency. These are the main volume per cycle into multiplied with the cycle per hour. The how much for taking and lifting and take away from place and come back to the again ready for the taking this. How much volume it is taking that multiplied with the hauling distance and the efficiency, whether filling it, because of natural is fill factor is more filling is happening to any boulders or uncut areas, so naturally the efficiency will be falling down. So cycle time 1 second, fixed cycle time is the variable cycle time is there. Cycle time is a fixed cycle time, spotting time, loading time, manoeuvre time, dumping time is the fixed cycle time. A variable cycle time is all the time return time. Spotting time, the time required for the unit to position itself in the cut and begin loading, including any waiting for the pushers. Place of application of road scrapper. It is generally suitable for the, it's already completed. Then Okay, yes, this is the actually production calculation. Yes, now I am going to concluding the scrapper chapters also. So far, you have learned the structure of the construction structure of the scrapper. What is the bowl and cutting the air prop, and also the how, what are the material the scrapper can able to lifting, and also the blade resistance, varying capacity of the blades, and also production calculations. This have the bowl, so that number of bowl capacity into cycle length, how much distance will go, and that kind of ready for the further. That is all can be calculated estimation of the production of the particular scrap. So these are the two HEMS, quantity HEMS. These are the auxiliary equipments for purpose of attachments. Various operations, the dozer and scrapper are play in a vital role for the purpose. So I hope these two are we are able to understand for the examination point of view. I would like to give summarizing all these main parts, function, place, application, dozer and road scrappers. I hope you are understanding the basic concepts, basic application, and this construction point of view, and construction efficiencies and production calculations. Now I am going to be giving the small feature. These are the applicable for the competition visit and other examination point of view, and also some concrete exam purpose it is helpful. Well, place application of dozer, where is it can be used? To clean the stumps of trees and shrubs, to prepare the ground, to make the road base. So both three dozer can be used to clean the stumps of trees and shrubs, to prepare the ground naturally, to make the road base. Yes, all the above is answer. Another question from the dozer given here. Which one of the following machinery used for preparing the ground for the mining operation? Whether dozer, scrapper, road grader, or they both. Road dozer can be used, rotor scrapper can be used, road grader is also used. So this is a general usage items for this purpose. Well, the frequently asked question of the for examination, academic examination purpose. List the different machineries for the preparing of the ground for mining operation. So this from this slides I am concluding that one. I wish you all the best. Thank you.